What's up, people? How's it going? Welcome to my channel and welcome to another video. I hope all of you have been safe and had a good weekend. We have quite a few people today on the road. I hope they have reasons for that. So how has everyone been? I hope good. I hope everybody is looking after themselves, and I hope some of you at least got yourselves vaccinated. I think the situation has dramatically improved. I don't know what could be the reasons for that, but I don't think now it's no longer one of those situations where, you know, you're spinning the wheel and hoping for the best. I guess by now many of you might have heard about it, but the American Airlines, United Airlines, is looking, or I think it recently signed a contract with a startup called Boom, United States itself, for supply of 15 to 16 supersonic aircrafts. And current estimates say that the transoceanic journey from London to New York would be cut down to 3-3.5 hours. So, which is a significant amount of time saving if you consider how current conventional mode of transports cost in terms of time, at least. So supersonic travel is not new per se. The last experiment called Concorde was wound down nearly 2 decades ago, and these Concorde aircrafts were being run by both British Airways and French Airlines. I don't know what's it called or what was it called, but these were the two airlines that were running these aircrafts. And one of the biggest impediments or biggest reasons why those aircrafts weren't really improved upon were essentially costs. So these aircrafts flew at Mach 2.0. which is twice the speed of sound. So one can imagine, you know, the amount of fuel that's required to operate these aircrafts. So in addition to large amounts of fuel that are required to sustain high-speed flight, it was also very expensive to maintain and operate these aircrafts. And typically, flight tickets, I think between London to New York or Philadelphia, was said to be around $10,000, which is enormous. Legend has it that Phil Collins, the legendary drummer of Genesis, the prog rock band Genesis, I'm not sure the legend is from his time in Genesis. Maybe it had to do with his solo career, but legend has it that he would perform concerts both at London and Philadelphia, for example, in states, in the same day. And this was largely possible due to the aircraft called Concorde. So, in spite of the time-saving benefits, as I mentioned before, the costs of operating it, maintaining it, were quite high. Which was a significant factor due to which, you know, the companies involved in, you know, maintaining or running these aircrafts didn't really invest any money in improving it or, you know, doing any innovations. And in addition to all these factors, its effects on environments are also disastrous. So I think the last straw as far as operability of this aircraft was the accident in which 200 people lost their lives. So once that happened, I think the nails were in the coffin, so to speak, and the aircraft was retired. However, 2 decades later, so it's not just this startup called Boom, but there are numerous startups in the United States who are looking at sustainable supersonic travel. So what do we mean by sustainable here? I think their definition of sustainability is net zero carbon footprint. So end-to-end operations would lead to net zero carbon footprint. So that's what all these startups, including Boom, who just signed a contract with United Airlines, is saying what their aircraft do. And United, on their part, have said that you know, if these 15 or 16 aircrafts that they plan to procure, I think for a total bill of around $2 billion, actually works out for them, they're ready to invest and buy 35 more. So I think that's probably a good indication of the industry, or at least United Airlines, I mean, on their confidence about the technologies that are under development at the startup called Boom. So I hope they are able to, you know, achieve the goals that they have set out for themselves. I think it will be a phenomenal achievement if they can keep the cost down, have little to negligible impact on the environment, and also, you know, make it economical to every one of us. So let's see how things pan out on that front. Today it drizzled quite a bit, so we could see some of the roads were damp, and the weather is mighty fine today. So with that, I'll sign off. I hope all of you are looking after yourselves and doing all the things that are needful. So until next time, peace.